Ma'am, are you saying anything? It's not audible, ma'am.
Guys, is it audible
Yes, ma'am.
God, my mic was off. Till now I was talking continuously. I was talking. Shit. It's okay. Let it be. Again, I'm okay to talk. It's okay, no problem. God. Yeah, see, till now how good I was explaining. Sure. Okay. See, we go back. So here I was talking about the logical design of IoT. Okay, my mic was off. Actually, in the phone I on it, but it was very far so that you couldn't listen. So it's okay, guys. See here, I'm talking about the IoT functional blocks. Okay, previously I discussed about the introduction, characteristics, and because why again and again I'm saying the topics names means you should not forget what are the topics are there. Okay, so and physical design. In the physical design, I discussed the IoT devices and protocols, right? So now we have functional blocks. Why this functional block the concept came? First, we see. Okay, in your portion, you have only the functional blocks. Coming to the IT people, they have logical design of IoT. You already learned about the physical design of IoT, right? But they have logical design of IoT. But from that logical design of IoT, it consists of three things. Okay, in that three things, we have only thing. One thing is that functional blocks of IoT. Okay, so here how this functional blocks of IoT topic can be understood, right? The logical design. You see, we have Facebook application. You have Facebook application, right? The Facebook application, when you open, you can see the appearance, like the outer part of the application. Like there you can see, when you open that on the screen, you can see the text fields, like enter your phone number or mail ID. So these kind of things are there, right? Okay, so those kind of things you can see. That is the outer part of the application. That is a physical design. They designed for the users. That is a physical design, right? That is having the logical design, inner part of the application. Like it will have different blocks, modules, the code, everything, right? So likewise, our IoT devices. Previously, I discussed, example, take our mobile phone. I explained you about the IoT devices. What are the devices are helping, right? So that devices, yeah, we have the devices. My mobile phone is also device, okay? I spoke about the protocols. This mobile phone, how it is connecting, what are the protocols which are supporting for the IoT devices, right? These things we have discussed. So here those things are over, right? So we are going to talk more
Ma'am,
depth
your
about
screen is not visible.
my screen is not visible. I didn't actually represent my screen, but I'm going to share my screen now. Yeah, now you can see. Okay. Yeah. This is the logical design of IoT. In that, we have functional blocks of IoT. An IoT system, it comprises of a number of functional blocks. Okay. Why the number of functional blocks? Because these provides the system the capabilities like identification, sensing, actuation, communication. Okay, because these are the capabilities which are differentiating our devices, like IoT devices, from other normal devices, right? So other devices, what are the functions they are performing? Same our IoT devices are performing. But why these are specially calling IoT device? Because they have the different capabilities, like sensing, actuation, identification, communication. So different way. Like you have your mobile phone, you want to communicate with the AC, you are communicating, right? So that is the reason. So you see here, we have the main functional blocks, six functional blocks we have. One is device, security, management, application, services, and the communication. These are the six functional blocks. Okay, this diagram you have to remember. Okay, these are the six functional blocks. In that, first, here the logical design of IoT system, it just refers to an abstract representation. This just abstract representation of the entities. Entities here in the sense the devices. Okay, see guys, here in our diagram we have devices one block, and security, communication, management, these all things we have, right? First we see what is this device, what it does. This device, in this IoT system devices, it provides the sensing, actuation, monitoring. We have devices, right? In the IoT system, these devices, it provides the sensing, actuation, monitoring, and control functions. Okay, this is the function of the block, the device block. Okay, this is the functioning of device block. And next thing, by the name itself, you can understand. The security. Security means what are the functions in the security comes? Actually, the functions, what are the functions it performs? Usually we know, right? Security means how we provide some security for any data. You see, like authentication, we provide authentication and authorization and message and content integrity and data security. So these all things the security block is going to perform. Okay, this block secures the IoT system by providing some functions. What are the functions? Like authentication, authorization, message, and content integrity and data security. Okay, these are the functions the security block is going to perform. Next thing we have communication. Communication means this communication block, it handles the communication for the IoT, entire IoT system. Okay, to the entire IoT system, this communication block is going to handle. Next thing, we have management. Management, in the management, the block, what it does, by the name itself, we can understand. This provides various functions to govern the complete IoT system. Okay, to rule completely this IoT system, this block, it provides it, you know, it governs the IoT system. Okay, how to perform like these all things it handles. Next thing we have security. Sorry guys, security is over, right? Services, it provides the services for device monitoring. Okay, what are the services this block is providing? It is providing the services like monitoring, device control, and some data publish, this kind of device control service and data publish services, and services like device discovery. Okay, what are the services it is providing? Device monitoring, where is the device, GPS tracking system, you know, right? So where is the device, and device control service and data publish services and services like device discovery. Okay, these all functions are going to perform by the services. Okay, next thing, what is the next block we have here? Application. This application is an interface. This is an interface. This block is an interface that users can use to control and monitor various aspects of the IoT system. Okay, users can use to control and monitor various aspects of the IoT system, and also it allows the users to view the system, and they can analyze and process the data also. Okay, it allows the users to view the complete system, and they can analyze and they can process the data. Okay, it basically it acts as an interface. Okay, this device, it provides some capabilities, right? So please guys, again I'm repeating, this device, this block, it provides the sensing, actuation, monitoring, and control functions. Okay. security. This block provides the authentication, authorization, message, and content integrity, data integrity. These functions we can perform by using the security. Okay, communication means it provides the entire communication for our entire communication for our entire IoT system. Here we are getting the services through this block. It provides the services like device monitoring, device discovery, and data publish services and data control services. Okay, so next thing, it completely governs this IoT system. Okay, this is management block. Next we have application. I told you, right? It acts as an interface. Okay, here the user can view complete IoT system and he can analyze and he can process the data. Okay, so this is all about functional blocks of IoT. Okay, so this guys is clear. This topic is clear, guys. Is that clear? Please let me know. Speak or please, you can text me in this chat. I'm waiting for your response. We move fast. We have to finish so many topics, right? We have to talk. If not, I will cover the same topic. Anybody, please. Okay,
Yes,
thank
ma'am.
you so much. Please, guys, one request from you. If you don't understand, please let me know that, okay? Because it will be helpful for me, okay? These guys are not understanding how to explain them properly, okay? Please, I don't mind it. Whatever it is, like you can say. Sorry, guys, because I'm feeling very bad. Before I was talking, but I didn't see that whether you are reaching or not, this topic is reaching you and you can hear or not. I didn't listen. I'm really sorry for that. Okay, the next topic here I'm talking about the sensing. Okay, sensing. Okay, what is sensing? Anybody knows? What is sensing? I will give you one example. See our bodies. Okay. Like you see, guys, we know that, right? Human beings collect information of the surroundings. How human beings are collecting information of the surroundings? The human beings are collecting the information about the like surroundings and all. Like by they have the sense organs. We have some sense organs, right? Sense organs, like we can call them as sensors also. Okay, the sense organs. What are the sense organs? We have eyes. Okay, my eyes are seeing something. That information I'm getting, right? So next, ears. You can hear something, and your skin. If something touch your skin, you can feel it. You can sense it, right? Nose, skin, everything. So our body also collects the information of the surround. Like we have some sense organs. Using the sense organs, we can collect some information, right? Same like we have IoT devices, right? Similarly, system must interact with their environment to do some useful task, right? Similarly, the system also how the human body is responding, right? With the sense organs, right? So likewise, the system also has to interact with the environment to do some useful tasks. So to do that, in our IoT we have two main components. Okay, our IoT system, it is consisting of two essential components. One is sensors and actuators. Okay, so without the use of sensors, there would be no automation. Okay, you can't switch on your AC or anything without use of sensors. Okay, and next, if we want any automation in system, we need sensors. Okay, these sensors are embedded in our bodies also. We can embed, like we can embed means attach. Okay, these sensors can be embedded in our bodies, our automobiles, airplanes, cellular telephones, radios, and chemical plants, industrial plants, and so many examples. Okay, so actually this sensor is a device. Okay, sensor is a device, a machine or a subsystem. Okay, what is the use of it? To detect some events, okay, or changes in its environment. To detect, to detect, or a sensor detects the changes in the ambient conditions or in the state of another device or a system, and forwards or processes this information in a certain manner. Okay, and see, that is the definition. I will explain you again. This, you see guys, this is the meaning. What is actually, if you type sensor, you can get this description from the Oxford University, like Oxford dictionary. Okay, the dictionary, you can get it. So a device which detects or a measures a physical property and records, indicates, otherwise responds to it. Okay, so what I want to say here, to detect any events or any changes in its environment, the sensor, it performs some actions, okay, so that it will detect some events or changes in its environment and send the information to its other electronic device. Okay, so likewise, it is sending some information to the other devices. It is detecting the changes and everything in the environment, and it is sending that information to the other devices in a certain manner. Okay, that is about the sensors. Okay, okay. So next we see what we have, the sensors. I told you, right, they perform some input functions by sensing and or feeling the physical changes in characteristics of a system in a response to stimuli. See guys, you have sensor, okay, weather sensor, okay, it is, you know, placed in a some weather condition, they are using, right, to get the weather report. So there it is detecting, okay, we placed some sensor in our room, so it has to detect when we are coming inside, the light should on, when we are going out. So in its environment, which place it's placed, it is what the changes it is detecting. Okay, and so guys, and one more example I want to give you here. Heat is converted to electrical signals, okay, by using so this is an example. I told you, right, the light is on, the light is off, I told you. Okay, here the heat means the light, it is up, it is seeing, guys wait a minute, heat is converted to electrical signals. I told you, right, heat means, you know, the temperature you are taking, the temperature it is taking, and how it has to pass, it has to pass to the system, right, the system which signals it can take. It can take only the electrical signals. One example I want to give you so that you can understand better. Yeah, I'm speaking, okay, through what I'm speaking, through using my microphone I'm using and I'm talking, right? So this earphone I'm using, what are the thing, you know, my voice is a sound waves, right? Sound waves, these sound waves, here I'm talking, you're not in front of me, but you're hearing my voice. How you're hearing this sound? The sound is going to be transformed into the electrical signals. These electrical signals are passing into the system. That signals you're hearing. Okay, how again the signals are transformed to the sound. Okay, so that you're hearing. If you're in front of me, means you can directly talk to me, but you're not in front of me, but still you're listening my voice. How? Because of the electrical signals. Okay, so likewise, to the system. System only can take the electrical signals. Okay, so this heat, whatever the things like heat or anything, guys, anything, the sensors are, you know, detecting so many things, right? Smoke sensors, so many, you know, weather, we are predicting the weather and everything, different sensors we are using, right? All the sensors to send that information to any system, it has to, you know, convert to the electrical signal. Okay, for example, heat is converted to electrical signals in a temperature sensor, or atmospheric pressure is converted to the electrical signals in a barometer. So what I'm saying, you know, even you take weather, even you take heat, anything, okay, it has to change to the electrical signal. Why it has to change to the electrical signal? Because that is connecting to a system. We are getting the devices, right? It has to reach any device, means obviously it should be in an electrical signal form. Okay, this you understood, I think. Okay, that is over. That you understood, guys. Okay, and here one more thing, transducers. Transducer means what it is, you know, it will convert one form of energy into other kind of energy. Okay, this helps. Okay, to transform, like heat is there, it has to change. It has to change means we have transducers. Okay, for example, I told you in a sound system, a microphone input device converts sound waves into electrical signals for an amplifier to amplify and a loudspeaker. Okay, see. You see, guys, I told you, right? In a sound system, we are using some microphone. It is converting my sound waves to electrical signals. That's what is okay. Okay, but next, what is happening, you know? And a loudspeaker, the output device, we have a loudspeaker, right? Again, the loudspeaker, what it does, this is converting the electrical signals till the system it is coming, okay? But this loudspeaker, what it does, this output device, it is converting that electrical signals back into again sound waves. That is the reason you are listening. One form of energy again converted to other form of energy. That is the transducers. Okay, these transducer helps to change. Okay, you understood why the transducers we are talking. These transducers are very important to change one form of energy into other kind of energy. Okay, so that is what. And next thing, we have some features, sensor features. Okay, it is only sensitive to the measured property. Means, example, a temperature sensor senses the ambient temperature of a room. Okay, we have to measure the temperature of a room. Okay, so to do that, we are using some specific what is that sensor? Okay, to do so, what kind of sensors we have? Thermistor and thermocouple, two kind of temperature sensors we have. So with this temperature sensor, it can detect the temperature in a room. Okay, when you place that sensor, it can detect the temperature of a room. Okay, the particular one. Next thing, it is sensitive to the measured property. Like, say, if you take the sensor, you know, what is the meaning of it? You know, if you take the thermistor or thermocouple temperature sensor, when you keep it in a room, definitely it will detect it. If you are taking anywhere, just it is designed for temperature, so obviously it will detect the temperature, it will measure the temperature. Okay. And next point, it is insensitive to any other property likely to be encountered in its application. See, what is the meaning of it, you know? Example, a temperature sensor does not bother about light or pressure while sensing the temperature. It is insensitive to any other property. You know, temperature sensor you take to some room and you placed there, it will detect only the temperature, but it won't bother about any light other features, like any other applications of light, like you have to on the light, you have to off the light. Those things it won't do that. Okay, if to do so, again you need other things, like, you know, it will measure room temperature, it will measure. Okay, on off again, to do so you need other sensor. Okay, so to just, it is not, you are seeing, right? Temperature sensor does not bother about the light or pressure while sensing the temperature. Okay, any pressure or means here other conditions. Okay, other conditions like pressure or something it can't detect, only it can detect the temperature. Okay, and it does not influence the measured property. Okay, measuring the temperature does not reduce or increase the temperature. Just you see, guys, it can just detect, that's it, but it can reduce or increase the temperature. It can't reduce or increase the temperature. Thus, you know, to do so, we have different sensors. Okay, you have one sensor, you should not think that I can do anything with the sensor. Okay, particular, if you take any sensor, it will have different capabilities. Okay, so it can perform for what it actually designed. Okay, so what is actually, it is only sensitive to the measured property, like for what it is designed, to that only it is sensitive. That thing only it can sense. Okay, temperature only it can sense if you use a temperature sensor. Okay, it is insensitive to other properties. Okay, like you can't measure the light or anything. Okay, you cannot Do so, those things. Okay, for light you cannot use, for pressure to measure it you cannot use the temperature sensor. Okay, so next thing, it does not influence the measure property, just it can take the temperature how much it is, that's it, but it cannot increase or reduce. Okay, through the sensor you cannot do those things. Okay, that those are the features of a sensor. Okay guys, and sensor resolution. Sensor resolution, here you take sensor resolution means resolution is the smallest change in the input device. Okay, the resolution of a sensor is the smallest change it can detect in the quantity. Okay, it can detect in the quantity the smallest change in the input device. Okay, that it is measuring, it can detect the smallest changes also. Okay, the resolution of a sensor with a digital output is usually the smallest resolution the out digital output is capable of processing, and the more is the resolution of a sensor, the more accurate its precision. Okay, so guys, if the you know if it is detecting smallest change, you see 10 degrees Celsius some temperature is there. Okay, but you know, but slight changes came. Slight changes means points. In the points, the data is there. Okay, in the points, the temperature is changing. The temperature is fluctuating. Then what it is, you know, it will show that 10.1. But actually, the sensor accuracy does not depend on its resolution. What happens, you know, this sensor can detect, you know, in the smallest changes. But you know, the sensor accuracy, like, it will give you like it accuracy, it does not depend on its resolution. Like, it will have the values like 10.1, 10.2 and all, but the accuracy of the sensor means, here you see guys, some things what happens, you know, points, in the points also we get the values, right? But finally, sometimes you will make it to 10 if you have 10.1, 10.2, 10.3, right? But still you will make the accuracy to 10, or depends on the value, right? So that's likewise, even it is having some precision, the sensor's accuracy does not depend on its resolution. Okay, this is about the resolution. The resolution means the smallest change, but even in the smallest changes also, this sensor's accuracy does not bother about it. Okay, even in the points you got the data also, here not required. Okay, even it can take in the digital form. Okay, the you know sensor does not depends on its accuracy. Okay, so guys, but it accurately takes the data. Okay, 10.1, if it is there, it will take like that, but it doesn't depend on that. Okay, does not depends on it. Is coming to the sensors. Okay, so here, till here you understood? Capturing raw data. Your understanding till here? Okay, if anything you didn't understand, please let me know, because this is, you people are thinking IoT means, I don't know in your opinion what it is, but because, but inside it is so much guys, please you have to listen it. It is not only like your subject, there are so many things you should know. Okay, so please you have to listen all the classes. Okay, and so many don't have you know proper attendance in IoT. Please attend the classes. Okay, and I am the person, I will see everything, each and everything in the exam. Okay, in each and everything you have to write, those things I consider so much. So please, and who is coming, who is not coming, I'm observing everything. I know your names also, even I'm new to this place, but still I know your names and all. Please guys, you know, don't neglect the classes. If you don't understand, ask me. Okay, till now guys, what are the things we discussed? You know, functional blocks we discussed, right? How many functional blocks we have, please let me know. I want to interact with you, I want your response also. Please, I don't want to talk myself, please interact with me. How many functional blocks we had before? Six, right? Yeah, okay, good. Okay, six we have, right? Now, what are the things in the sensors? We have discussed what is actually sensor. It is detecting any changes in the environment and it is sending that information to the other devices, right? So, and next we have different things like, transducers. This transducer, it is transforming one kind of energy into other kind of energy. So I gave you example already, right? Loudspeaker and microphone. Okay, microphone, it's an input device, right? It's a headphone is an input device because you are placing it to your device, right? So it's an input device. It is converting the sound waves, my voice, into the electrical signals, and that voice is reaching you through the loudspeaker into the again sound waves. Again, here I'm talking, you are listening there. Please guys, this is general knowledge. Okay, so please hear your focus, how you are getting again my sound using the loudspeaker options, right? So that is again converting the electrical signals back into the sound waves. And here you have, what is that? You have, one thing I want to say here, I told you, right, in Internet of Things we have two components. One is sensors and actuators, right? The sensors, just it is taking the information and the action where it is going to perform, which is performing the action. Is it the sensor is going to perform action? Sensor, just it is having only the capability is of sensing. That's it. The action, who is going to perform? Who is going to perform is, who is going to perform here? The actuators actually. Okay. So these things we see when I'm going to talk about those things. The word transducer is a collective term used for both sensors, which can be used to sense a wide range of different energy forms, such as movement, electrical signals, radiant energy, thermal or magnetic energy, and actuators, which can be used to switch voltages or currents. Okay, actuators. Okay, these actuators are going to perform the action. Okay, so your sensors just can sense, but the main thing, who is transforming here? I told you, right, transforming one kind of energy into other kind of energy. We are using transducers, I said, right? But the action is going to perform by using the actuators. Okay, so this transducer is a combination of sensors and the actuators. It is getting the input from the sensor and the action it is going to perform using the actuator. Okay, it is invoking, like you can see, to get the in, you know, this transducer, it is a mediator, like it is a collective term. It is a combination of both. Like sensor, it is taking the input from sensor, and after taking that, sensor can't perform any action. To do so, this sensor again, it is this transducer, it is changing the sensor energy. Here it is taking this sound waves, right? The sound waves are going to perform, transformed into electrical signals. After taking this electrical signals by using this actuator, that it going to perform the action. If we see, we have actuators topic different. Okay, so after the sensors, we have actuators. There you can understand how it is going to perform and all. You don't need to bother about it. Okay, so here you are understanding. You understand only one thing, that one kind of energy is going to transform into other. Okay, so like here one more thing, what we discussed, some features. Like if you take any temperature sensor, it can only detect the temperature, that's it. Okay, and next, it is not in, it is only incense, it is just insensitive. Before, it is sensitive to just the room temperature. Like in the room temperature, it can sense, it can be sensitive, but if it is insensitive to other applications of the like light, pressure in the room, so many things are there, pressures, other kind of things. If you want to measure, it won't consider those things, only temperature it can detect. And next thing, it won't influence any measured property. Like a measured property, what it is, I measured the temperature, that is a measured property. Okay, but it is not influencing that property. Temperature I measured, but I'm not the sensor which I'm using, it is not influencing, like it is not reducing or decreasing. Okay, so I think you understood that. Sensor resolution, this is the smallest change. Okay, the smallest change in the device in the data, but that data, like, it is not bothered about the resolution. Okay, coming to the sensor resolution, not only sensor resolution, you have your devices, TV, everything. Everything is having the resolution. Okay, good resolution you need. Some things you will talk right about the devices and features. In the coming to the features, we talk so many things. Okay, so I will continue. And okay guys, till here we discussed, right? So we see the next thing. We have sensor classes. In the sensors also we have classes, okay, based on the output. Okay, based on the output, the sensors are divided into two types. Okay, one is the analog sensors and digital sensors. Okay, based on the output. And next thing, based on the data type. Okay, again, based on the data type, we have scalar sensors and the vector sensors. Here I told you, right, based on the output, we have analog and digital signals. You see here what happens, you know, the sensors is taking the output in the waveform, something in the waveform, like you see water flow. You have to control or detect the water flow, right? So that it comes under the analog sensors. Okay, and next thing, light on or off, that comes under the digital sensors. Here, light on or off, how it works, you see guys, how it works, that light on or off, zeros and ones we get the output, light on or off, right? That is in the zeros and ones. But here waveform, it is this analog output, the output which we are getting in the analog sensors, it will be in the form of analog. Okay, analog sensor, like see here is waveform means it's like 0.1, like water flow you see in a water tanker. I'm worried about my time because I have to take the attendance, right? So guys, this topic I will discuss. Just I want to tell you two things. In the analog sensors, this data, you know, the output comes in a waveform. In the digital, it comes in the zeros and ones. Okay, zeros and ones we get that. Okay, when it is zero, and when it is one, so the digital, that you know, like we get the information in the digital sensors. In the analog sensors, we get the information in the waveform. Like here, only zeros and ones in the digital sensors, but here it can take 0.1, 0.2. Likewise, we get the data. Okay, in the analog sensors, that is the reason it is in the waveform, and this is just in the like digital form. Okay, so that is I discuss with you in the next class. For today, you give me the attendance. Don't bother about the sensor classes. We will have a very good class in the next time. We will discuss very good explanation. We can expect, and I can expect the very good reply from you also, guys. So please, for today, you give me your attendance. I'm ending the class for today, and tomorrow we discuss sensor classes, analog sensors. This is very important, sensor classes and everything. Okay, analog sensors, digital sensors, and what are the types of sensors we have. These things also I'm going to cover. So these are all things we have, and what are the errors comes in the sensors. Okay, so these things we discuss. And the next thing, actuators also very important. Please guys, do attend the classes, don't miss any class. So for today, I'm going to take the attendance. Please replay when I call your numbers. Okay guys, it